back, students. In the previous class, we have discussed about the topic interrupt service mechanism. Now we will discuss two topics. That is, first one is multiple interrupts, and second one is DMA, direct memory access. First one is multiple interrupts. Okay, first one is multiple interrupts. Second one is DMA, direct memory access. Okay, so let's discuss about multiple interrupts first. Okay, so multiple interrupts means there is a process running, you will get n number of interrupts at the same time. Okay, generally there are n number of interrupts. Okay, the process will assign a priority for the interrupts. Okay, depends upon the priority, the respective highest priority interrupt will be serviced first. Anyway, let's go into topic. So certain process permit in between routine diversion to higher priority interrupts unless all interrupts are interrupts of priority, listen, interrupts of priority greater than the presently running routine are masked or ISR executed DA instruction. Okay, means there is some process called A running. Okay, and we got some interrupt. You got some interrupt. If this interrupt B, has highest priority than A, okay, we will give priority. Okay, priority means importance. Okay, you are giving A has lesser importance than B. B has greater importance. Okay, so B is a highest priority. We will assign the order. The operating system will assign the order. The priority, for example, there are four tasks running. The highest priority is D, C, B, A. Okay, so D is the highest priority. C is the second highest priority. B is the third highest priority. A is the fourth highest priority. Understand? So, if the interrupt is B, means B has the highest priority, then B is serviced. Okay. For example, if the task D is running, okay, the interrupt came from B. So D has the highest priority, B has the less priority. So then this interrupt is ignored. The interrupt is ignored and B will not be serviced. B will be serviced after finishing B. When the task B will get finished, then the interrupt B is serviced. Okay? And first suppose we will get the n number of it at the same time. Okay? We got the interrupt at the same time, okay, B, C, at the same time, okay, then also D is the highest priority. If task A is running now, then on B and C, which will be serviced? C will be serviced. Why? By stopping task A, C will be serviced because C has the highest priority. Understand? What is meant by priority? So coming back, certain process permit in between routine diversion. See, routine diversion means when we get some interrupt, we have to go to the respective vector address and the ISR will be loaded in the program counter. Okay? That is nothing but a routine diversion. Okay, routine means program. Already a task A is running. Okay, and it has to be diverted. Why? When it will be diverted? When we get some interrupt. Okay, so in between the routine diversion to higher priority interrupts, unless all interrupts are priority greater than the presently running routine. Okay, priority greater than the presently running routine. Priority greater than the presently running routine are masked or DA using a DA instruction, disable interrupt. Okay, disable interrupt is 0. Then it will accept the interrupts. Okay, presently running routine are masked. Masked means the interrupts are, you can allow the interrupts. Okay, next. The process provided in order to prevent diversion in between the running IS completely by provisioning for masking all interrupts by primary level bit or DI instruction. Okay. Masking. Okay. Masking all the interrupts. Means by using the DI register, we may enable or we may disable. Means here masking means what? Mask interrupt means what? Depending upon the bit register value, we can enable the interrupt, we can disable the interrupt. So here, the register is here the DI. Here DI equal to 1. Means interrupts are disabled. Won't accept any interrupts. Okay, like that. So these processes also provide in order to prevent diversion between the running ISR selectively. Okay, by provisioning for masking selectively. And the interrupt service by secondary level bits for the ISR interrupt source group selectively. Okay, so we can program. See, I have mentioned ABCD. Okay, ABCD, D has the highest priority, C is the second highest priority, okay, B is the third highest priority, A is the least priority. Okay, I have assumed like that. Here also selectively we can mask the interrupts. Selectively, we can mask the interrupts means we can selectively allow the interrupts. We may allow the interrupt from one respective device only. We may allow one interrupt for the timer one only. Like that, selectively, we can enable the interrupts also. The interrupt service by secondary level for the ISR interrupt possible. Next, these processes may also provide for auto saving the CPU registers. See, after we will get the interrupts, the respective running task will be saved. Okay, that is nothing but a context. The context is being saved. ISR region starts and auto returns saved values into the CPU registers on return from ISR. After servicing the respective interrupts, it will be saved. ISR will be, interrupt service routine will be generated. It will be serviced, get back. And again, see here context. Context means context switching. Task here running. Okay, interrupt came, switch it to some other context. Here the context is saved. Okay, that respective interrupt is serviced. Get back. Okay, after servicing completed, okay, after servicing the respective interrupt, it get back and resume the current running task again. Okay, this is the general process. The context means the context has to switch from A, task A, to some interrupt B. Again, from from B to A. Okay. So context from A to B is being switched. Context from B to A is again switched. That is nothing but context switching. So diversion to higher priority interrupts at the end of the present interrupt service routine only. Okay. End of the. Diversion to higher priority interrupt means interrupt came, task is set to be running. Interrupt came, diverted to highest priority. Since the interrupt is highest priority, some task A has been stopped and it is serviced. So diversion is diverted to some highest priority interrupt at the end of when it is diverted at the end of the present interrupt service routine only. The end of the present interrupt service routine means after completing the task. Okay. So here this is a process, and highest priority interrupt event occurs at T1 after T0. Okay, at T0 the service is being started. Interrupt service routine started, and interrupt came at T1. Okay, next starts after T2 plus T dash only, where T is the context switch time. Okay. So let's note it. ASR should be coded short to enable the hypertensor to get the additional. Simple, okay? The thing is, since diversion to highest priority interrupts at the end of the present interrupt service only, means it is not accepting any interrupts. It is not accepting any interrupts. So here, at T0, some task A is running here also. Some task A is running, which is started at T0. At T1, it got some interrupt. Okay. Next, and it is switched. Task A is running. Okay. Task A is running here also. Or get a single one. Task A is running, okay, this is with respect to time, okay, so at time t1, task A is running, okay, so what is the switching time? Switching time means A has to stop, okay, A task has to stop, context must be saved, okay, and it will be switched to some respective interval. Okay, that is nothing but T1 plus some switching time T dash is the switching time given. Okay, here some task started T0, interrupt occurs at T1, okay. So when the high priority ISR will be generated after completing the time T2. Okay. So it is completed at time T2. Some task, okay, task named A, let it be A. Okay, A started at time T0. Okay. Next, the priority interrupt. Interrupt occurs at T1. Okay. And even the interrupt occurred, okay, it is not being serviced, and the presently running ISR is completed at T2. Okay, after completing the present task, it is switched. So what is the time? T2 plus T dash. What is T dash? T dash is switching time. So what is switching time? After getting some interrupt, the task must be completed, okay, and it will again, the respect to higher priority task has to be serviced, okay, in order to service the time, there will be some delay, okay, so that delay time is called the switching time. That means it has to shift from the currently running task to the highest priority task. That is called switching time. Diversion to higher priority interrupts at the end of the present interrupt service routine only. Means it is a maskable interrupt. Okay. Maskable interrupt means we are disabling the interrupts. Okay. While the current task is running, the interrupts are not allowed. After finishing the respect to ISR only, we are servicing the interrupt. Even though it is a high priority task. So the process starts execution at time T0. At T1, it got some interrupt. Even though it got some interrupt, it continues running, okay, because it is a maskable. We are disabling all the interrupts in this example. Okay, after completing T2, finishes at time T2. Okay, considering the switching time also, that is, starts after, means the highest priority task, the higher priority ISR, starts after time T2 plus T dash, means completion of the ISR time plus T dash, context switching time, only where T dash is the context switching time. Okay, so when the higher priority ISR started, T2 plus T dash. So ISR should be quoted short, not enable the help at ISR to get the attention cost. Okay, ISR means interrupt get. Okay, got some interrupt. It has to switch. It has to switch after completion of the currently, presently running ISR. Okay, so this ISR must be quoted short in order to reduce the switch, context switching time. Okay, the context switching time is reduced, we consider it as a cost. Okay, this is the first one with respect to diversion of the highest priority. Next, second figure. That here also diversion to higher priority interrupts from the presently present interrupt service routine. Okay. Here at the end of the, have to note this, at the end of the present interrupt service routine, after completing the ISR, the first figure. In the second figure, there is no end. Okay. In between diversion to higher priority interrupts from the present interrupt service routine. Means it is a non-maskable interrupt. Non-maskable interrupt means we have to service. Because the interrupt we are getting during the process is the highest priority task. Here also, at T0, the process started the execution. Okay. At T1, we got the interrupt. High priority interrupt event occurs at T1. After T0, at T1 we got the interrupt. Okay. Next, T1 is stopped. Okay. Okay. The presently running task stops at T1. And after that, starts after time T1 plus T dash, where T dash is the context switching time. Okay. Means the interrupt is serviced at T1 plus T dash. Interrupt is serviced at T1 plus T dash. Next again, after the interrupt is serviced at T1 plus T dash, again it finishes as a time, resumes at time, finishes at time T2. Again, resumes at time T2 plus T dash. Okay. Simply here, at T0, okay, consider a task A, they are running, at T0 it is running, okay, T1, we got interrupt, let's take some figure, they are running, A is running, at T0 it is running, at T1 it got an interrupt, at T1 it got an interrupt, right. Next, what will happen? It will be saved. Some context switching time will be there, that is T1 dash, okay, or T dash. Some T dash or T dash, that is T dash, context switching time will be there, some T dash, then some interrupt name would be, the interrupt is B, then B will run, okay, then B will be running, at what time? T1 plus T dash, T1 and means considering the switching time, next it will complete at a time some T2. B will complete at time T2. Next, there will be again some context switching time. Again some context switching time. It is considered as some T dash only again. Okay. Then when the again task A will start? Then again some T2 plus T dash. T2 plus T dash. Okay. At T naught, the process is running. I will show you the figure 2. T naught is running. At T1, I got some interrupt. Switching time is T dash. So, the B running time started at T1 plus T dash. Okay. T1 plus T dash. T1 plus T dash, and again at T2 is task B, or is the interrupt is being completed. Yes, again on some context switching from B to A. So time is T dash again. Okay. So again the starting time of task A is again T2 plus T dash. Right. Here also present same. Here processor started some T0. T0 started. Okay. High priority interrupt event occurs at T1. Next, then it will stop at time T1. Okay. Next, again, what happened? There is the third step. First step is at some T0 it has started. Second step is, okay, some interrupt occurred at T1. Third step is it stops at time T1. Fourth step is starts after time T1 plus T dash, where T dash is the switching time. Okay. Next, fifth step is resumes. Okay, sorry. Fifth step is the high priority ISR is serviced and finishes at time T2. And last step is resumes at time T2 plus T dash. Okay. This is the process. First one is at T0, it is running. Step 2, at T1 get an interrupt. Step 3, so at T1 it get an interrupt, then it will stop. The currently running ISR will get stopped. Okay. Next, fourth step is T1, considering the switching time also, stopped, stops and we get switched to the interrupt. So switching time, T dash is considered. T1 plus T dash is considered. Next, fifth step. Means it went to the respective highest priority task. Fifth step, it will complete. The interrupt is completed. Interrupt is serviced. It will complete. Finishes at time T2. Then after servicing the respective interrupt, it will get back to the normal process again. That is, let it be A. Okay. So resumes at time T2 plus T dash. So if it completed time T2 and it will switch from the interrupt to again the current running task. T2 plus T dash again. T dash is the context switching time. Okay. So, hardware assignment of priorities. Okay. Certain interrupts need faster attention. Okay. For example, see, this means hardware assignment of priority means how you will assign the priority. There are n number of devices. Okay. So, n number of hardware interrupts and n number of hardware software interrupts. So, how you will assign the priority? Okay, what are the signals, device drivers, exceptions, traps to be considered while assigning some priorities? Okay, as for example, a clock interrupt on a system timer, overflow. Okay, give some indicate some priority there. So detection of illegal opcode by the processor, division by zero. Next, when there are some multiple device drivers, traps, exceptions, signals due to the hardware and software interrupts, the assignment of the priorities for each source or source code is required. So see, these things discuss with respect to the processor, with respect to the internal device drivers, okay, internal device included, what are the, how we are assigning the priorities. We must program the priorities. So, with respect to processor, okay, there are some type of interrupt requests. Here we indicate, for example, IRQ interrupt request and fast interrupt requests are FIQs. Okay, with respect to ARM 7, with respect to 8086, we assign the priorities from 0 to 255. Okay, so 0 stands for the highest priority, 1 stands for second highest priority, 2 third highest priority, 3 fourth highest priority. Like that, the least priority goes to 255. Second step resembles that. Next, see, this talk, this discussion is about multiple interrupts, okay? This discussion is about multiple interrupts. In multiple interrupts, we have discussed about n number of interrupts, how we will mask, enable and disable the interrupts. Next, we have taken two examples. That is, one highest priority is getting interrupted and we are completing the SR and servicing the respect to highest priority. That is this figure. And second one is, first one is with respect to maskable interrupt. Second one is with respect to non-maskable interrupt. Okay, I have clearly explained this figure. Here, I am stopping the presently running ISR and servicing the highest priority interrupt here. So, this is about multiple interrupts topic. Okay, and about the assignment of priorities, how we will assign. I just discussed the theory there. And so, in this class, the last topic is DMA. Okay, direct memory access. Direct memory access. See, the processor in the system has n number of tasks to do. The processor in the system has n number of tasks to do. So, while transferring some data with respect to memory, okay, the processor need not be involved in every step of the transferring process. Okay, so here in direct memory access, there will be some direct memory access controller which used to act as a mediator between the processor and the memory. When you are transferring some bulk of data from a memory to memory, okay, no need to be processed to be involved at every step of the transaction. Okay, the DMAC, direct memory access controller, will only involve at starting of the process at the ending of the process. Okay, this is about DMAC. Why? Because for everything informing to the processor, okay, takes time. Okay, everything informed to the processor takes time. That's why, see, repeatedly interrupting the processor for transferring of every byte during bulk transfer of data will waste too much of processor time in context switching. See, the processor has to monitor every memory transaction, every data transaction, what is going on is somewhat difficult and it takes time. Okay, now the copying process or the transferring process will take more time. That's why we are including a direct memory access controller in between the processor and the memory, so that the direct memory access will take care about the transferring process. So let's go through it. DMA is required when multi-byte data set or burst of data or a block of data is to be transferred between the external device which is connected and system or two systems. It may be between two systems or it may be some input-output device in the system. Second, a device facilitates DMA transfer with a processing element. Okay, as I already discussed, the processing element is, as I mentioned, DMAC. That is direct memory access control. Okay. So, why we are using DMAC? Because repeatedly interrupting the processor for every transaction is a time-taking process. That's why we are including a DMAC in order to take action with respect to the transferring part between an external device in the system or between the two systems. So, system performance improves by separate processing of the transfers from and to the peripherals. For example, they have given example with respect to a camera memory and the USB port. Okay. So these are the interconnections. So this is the processor and this is the RAM. And these signals may include some chip select signal or some read bar. Write bar, etc. Okay, since it is a RAM, can read or write. Okay. Next one, this is the bus interface unit. BIU stands for bus interface unit. And there are some addressing buses, 16-bit address bus and 8-bit data bus is involved. And this is the main part what we are discussing about DMA C. That is DMA controller. Okay. So these are the signals involved with respect to DMA. The bus hold request, bus available acknowledgement, and DMA request with respect to memory. Okay, DMA acknowledgement, and these are the devices and the port connected to DMAC. And this DMA used to inform the processor. See, DMA used to take care about the memory transaction. For every memory transaction involved, no need of the processor to be involved at every step, because the processor has n number of tasks to do. Because so the memory transaction is given right to the DMAC. So DMA will inform the processor that there is a transaction is being processed, it is going to start, and the transaction is completed. That's it. Okay, the starting of the transaction and the ending of the transaction is only involved. Remaining transferring part will be taken control by the DMAC. So it is a direct memory access. Since informing everything to the processor takes time, the processor gives this responsibility to DMAC. DMAC informs the processor that the memory reading is going to takes place, the memory reading completed. Our memory writing is going to take place, memory writing completed. That is starting of the transaction and ending of the transaction only, the DMAC used to inform the processor. Then only the processor is involved. In the remaining time, the processor involved in the different operation and makes the system fast. Right? This is about DMAC. So after the ISR initiation program, the DMAC sends the hold request. Okay? Hold request to the CPU. And then CPU acknowledges. Okay. These are the steps already discussed, and these are the modes. There will be some single transfer mode, burst transfer mode, and the bulk transfer mode. Okay, involved in direct memory access controller. And DMA proceeds without CPU intervention, means without processor intervention. The DMA proceeds the transaction. Okay, that is at the start of the DMAC programming initialization, and at the end, only at the starting of the memory transaction and the ending of the transaction only, the C processor is said to be involved. The remaining process will be taken care of by DMAC. Okay, so whenever a DMA request by an external device is made by DMAC, the CPU is requested. Of course, it will request the CPU. The DMAC will inform the processor regarding the interrupt signal. Okay, and we will get an acknowledgement now to start or initiate the program, and the notification we will get. Okay, these things are noted in this figure. Okay, these things are noted in the figure that where the board, the input or output board, is asking some request, and we are getting some, the device is getting some acknowledgement. Okay. These are mentioned in the figure. So while studying, go through the figure once. So when a DMA controller is used to transfer a block of bytes, okay, generally the ISRs are not called here. The ISR is called only at the beginning of the transfer of the program, okay, and at the end of the transfer. Because we have to switch, okay, we have to switch that the respective transfer is going to complete and the respective transfer is going to stop. Then we will use the ISRs. Next, multiple channel DMAC. Okay, multiple channel DMAC means not if there is only one device, we can use one DMAC controller. If there are n number of devices, we have to use n number of DMAC. Means direct memory access controllers. So provides DMA action from system memories and for two or more devices. Separate set of registers for programming each channel. So we have to maintain separate set of registers. Okay, if there are n number of input and output devices exist, and a separate interrupt signals in case of a multi-channel DMAC. Multi-channel means, of course, there exists some multi-channel DMAs which controls some n number of devices. Okay, even though if the number of input outputs increases, and if we want to follow direct memory access, so we have to use multiple channel DMAs. With respect to multiple channel DMAs, direct memory access controllers, we have to make sure about the number of registers and the separate interrupt signals involved with respect to each input and output device. Okay, so this is about the topic DMAs. Okay, so in this class we have discussed about two topics. One is with respect to
multiple interrupts, and the second one is with respect to DMA,
direct memory access.
In the next class, we will deal with these two topics, that is device level programming, the concepts of C versus memory access. Okay, thank you.